Thank you for joining in on this introduction to the woodwind family and for our rendition of the storytime masterpiece, Peter and the Wolf. I will show you where you can typically find woodwind instruments doing what they do best, adding their voices to the symphony orchestra. Here is a swiftly built imaginary orchestra, which, until we straighten out our ability to meet together in large groups indoors, is where the orchestra will reside, in your mind's eyes. Ta-da! Before hearing the whole story of Peter and the Wolf, let's first get to know each woodwind instrument individually. Jacqueline DeVoe will tell you about her favorite instrument, the flute.
Hello everyone, my name is Jackie and I play flute in the North Wind's Quintet. The flute is a very popular instrument and the one that I chose to learn in the fourth grade because I loved the sound. Sergei Prokofiev, the composer of Peter and the Wolf, decided that the flute should represent a little bird, Peter's friend. Do you think this sounds like a bird? Now I'd like to introduce my colleague Andrea, who is going to tell you about her oboe. Here's Andrea.
My own instrument was made in France about 15 years ago, but it is actually the result of musicians who around 3,000 years ago lived on the northwest edges of Africa. And these musicians invented instruments using a pair of reeds, a dried out plant, attached to the end of a tube. Really, quite an extraordinary invention. And looking at a map, it's easy to see that Southern Europe and North Africa are not very far apart, so over many centuries, both continents traded ideas and experiments. Eventually, French instrument makers created a version, this version, of the oboe that developed into a regular member of the mid-17th century orchestra. Here's the theme Prokofiev wrote for the oboe in Peter and the Wolf, portraying the carelessness of the duck character who doesn't have the most happy of outcomes. Clarinet, another member of our quintet today that in appearance resembles the oboe but has a whole different storyline.
The name of this tree that the clarinet and the oboe comes from is called the impingo tree. Let's go to my computer and take a look. So, here is a picture of the impingo tree, spelled M-P-I-N-G-O. And these trees are found on the eastern side of Africa from Ethiopia, Kenya, Tanzania, and Mozambique. The inside of the impingo tree trunk, the black keys on the piano can come from this tree as well. Artisans in Africa like to use this tree to make sculptures. Let's look at one. Way awesome. They made that right out of the trunk there. She's gorgeous.
I play the cat.
Now, we're going to hear from Greg, and he plays a really big instrument.
Are you playing in Peter and the Wolf?
Grumpy old grandfather.
Hmm.
Hello, my name's Michael. I play the French horn. This is a brass instrument, technically not a woodwind. We sneak into the woodwind quintet because of our ability to blend very well with other instruments. What I'm going to do now, with the help of a little technology through GarageBand, is to play the wolf theme, which comes about midway through the story. And to get in character, I have my wolf mask, which is pretty scary. And we're going to try this now. Here goes.
And now that you've heard each of us individually, we would like to play the story of Peter and the Wolf for you. We hope you enjoy it.
Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow.
"Look out!" shouted Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. The duck whacked angrily at the cat.
In her excitement, jumped right out of the pond.
But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, catching up with her. And then the wolf got her, and in one gulp,
gulp,
swallowed her whole.
Peter, sitting up in the tree, yelled, "Do not shoot! Birdie and I have already caught the wolf. Now help us take him to the zoo." Imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head, and after him, the hunters leading the wolf. Up the procession came Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather tossed his head discontentedly. Well, and if Peter had not caught the wolf, what then?
Thank you.